Did you know? In 1999, Austrian physicist Anton Zeilinger and his team conducted an experiment that quietly made history. It wasn't as famous as Schrödinger's cat or the double slit experiment with electrons, but it delivered a groundbreaking message. Wave function collapse doesn't require an observer's consciousness. The team replaced electrons with something much bigger, C60 fullerenes, also known as buckyballs, molecules made of 60 carbon atoms. When sent through a double slit, these molecules behaved like waves, creating an interference pattern. But then, something strange happened. When the molecules were heated, their wave-like behavior disappeared. Instead of an interference pattern, they left two simple spots on the screen, acting like particles. Why? Because heated molecules emit infrared radiation, tiny light signals that interact with the environment. Which leads to, infrared radiation itself carries information, since infrared photons interact with the environment. In theory, an external observer could deduce the fullerene's path from these emitted photons. Environmental interference with the quantum system, decoherence. When the fullerene's infrared radiation becomes entangled with the environment, the quantum superposition is disrupted, causing the wave-like behavior to disappear. This means the universe itself could know which slit the molecule passed through. No human observer needed. The environment alone was enough to measure the system and collapse the wave function. This was the first clear proof that wave function collapse isn't about human consciousness, but about information leaking into the world. But this experiment didn't just challenge old interpretations of quantum mechanics, it also pushed the boundaries of how big something can be while still obeying quantum laws. This was the first time quantum interference was observed at the scale of large molecules. Since then, scientists have tested even bigger molecules, reaching over 25,000 atomic mass units. Some are even considering interference experiments with viruses or bacteria. So, at what point does quantum weirdness fade into classical reality? We still don't know. But this quiet, overlooked experiment may have been one of the first steps toward answering that question. It showed us that even the universe itself can be an observer.